हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट फ्रॉम द चैप्टर क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिराइव द कंडीशन फॉर कॉमन रूट ऑफ टू क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। ओके, एंड दिस क्वेश्चन और कॉमन रूट रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन इज वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर योर आईएससी एग्जाम एंड ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर आईआईटी और एनी अदर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम। ओके, सो फर्स्ट आई विल डिराइव द कंडीशन फॉर कॉमन रूट ऑफ दिस टू क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस बी एक्स प्लस सी इक्वास टू जीरो एंड अनदर पी एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस क्यू एक्स प्लस आर इक्वास टू जीरो। ओके, सो आई हैव कंसिडर्ड हेयर टू क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। सो फर्स्ट सी, टू डिराइव द कंडीशन वी आर कंसिडरिंग दैट लेट alpha be the common root, be the common root of the given quadratic equations. So common root means what? Common root means alpha is the root of the first quadratic equation as well as the second quadratic equation. Common means our root will be same for both of the equation. So I have considered here that alpha be the common root of the given quadratic equations. Okay, given quadratic equations. Okay, then since alpha is the root of the first equation as well as alpha is the root of second equation, so alpha must be the equation must be satisfied by alpha. Okay, no doubt, since alpha is the root, so by alpha the first equation will be satisfied, also second equation also be satisfied. Is it clear? So if we put in the first equation, then it will be a alpha square plus b alpha plus c equals to 0, and if you put in the second, then it is p alpha square plus q alpha plus r equals to 0. So now our target, our main target is to eliminate alpha. Okay, and we are going to calculate the condition. So since alpha is a variable which is introduced by me, so we can't keep this variable alpha in the condition. Okay, so now I am applying cross multiplication method. Then by cross multiplication here alpha square by alpha by 1 by. Okay, so when alpha square by, that time we have to hide this first column and we have to consider the coefficient of alpha. That means alpha square alpha, we are solving for alpha square and alpha. So alpha square alpha are variable here. So if we hide the first one, if you multiply this part, then this is BR. Okay, so BR and minus CQ. You know, I hope all of you know how to do by cross multiplication methods. BR minus CQ. When we'll consider alpha by, so we have to hide this part and we have to consider CP, this side to this side. So CP minus, according to the formula, there will be minus AR. Clear? And 1 by, that means we have to hide this part. So if we consider this part, then this is AQ minus BP. Clear? Next. So if we consider the first and last ratio, then we will get from first and last, first and last ratio, first and third ratio. But if we consider this, then alpha square will be equals to BR minus CQ by AQ minus BP. This is alpha square. And if you consider the second and third, then from second and third ratio, we will get alpha equals to Cp minus Ar by Aq minus Bp. Clear? So if we try to eliminate alpha from these two equations, then we have the value of alpha. So easily we can calculate alpha square, and this alpha square and this will be equal. Okay, so alpha square means this square. So right here, eliminating alpha, then this square, then it is alpha square Cp minus Ar by Aq minus Bp whole square is equals to Br minus Cq by Aq minus Bp. Since this is alpha square and this is also alpha square, if we consider whole square both side, then it is alpha square, so we can equate it. Now if we simplify, then we can distribute the whole square. So this is square and denominator is square, so denominator one time will be cancelled out, and finally we will get Cp minus Ar whole square by Aq minus Bp whole square equals to Br minus Cq by Aq minus Bp. So both of the denominator be Aq minus Bp, so here square is there, here one time, so we can cancel out one time. So if we cancel out one time, then it will be Cp minus Ar by Aq minus Bp. So numerator will be square, this one times, and it right hand side Br minus Cq. Okay, now if we consider cross multiplication, then Cp minus Ar whole square equals to Aq minus Bp into Br minus Cq. Okay, so this is the eliminant form, and this is the condition of common root, which is the condition for common root. Okay, which is the condition for common root. Clear? So now this condition you have to memorize. Okay, who will appear the IIT JAM exam or any other competitive exam, they have to memorize this condition, this last line. Okay, since you will not get your time to derive it again, so you have to memorize it to solve the problem very fast. It is clear? So now how to memorize? If you memorize straightforward, then it will be very complicated. Okay, so next I am telling you the tricks that how to memorize this condition. Okay, very easy tricks. How? So how to memorize, I am telling you the tricks. So x square plus bx plus c equals to 0, this is the first quadratic equation, and px square plus qx plus r equals to 0, this is the second quadratic equation. So no need to memorize thoroughly, I am telling you the tricks. So first write the coefficient here, a, b and c, these are the coefficient a, b, c, and secondly p, q, r, p, q, r. So the condition will be just a, r, that means first corner to last principal diagonal, minus this diagonal, this is square. So a, r minus p, c whole square equals to, now first consider this and apply cross multiplication, and secondly consider this. So here aq minus pb, always you have to consider this diagonal, okay, this diagonal minus this diagonal, this is the first, this is the second. So if you consider this diagonal, then aq minus bp into, now consider this second, this is br minus cq, so br minus cq. So this is the condition for common root. Understood? So no need to memorize thoroughly. First you have to consider the long diagonal. Okay, long diagonal means ar and pc, this is the long. After that the two short diagonals are there, first this and second this. Hope you will understand. that how to memorize. So this is the condition for common root. Okay, now sometimes this type of questions also come, that what are the possibility for common root, what are the possibility for common root. So see here, I have got one thing for here, we have one thing that alpha square by alpha by and 1 by this. So from this proportion, from this proportion, alpha is the common root. That means the possibility of alpha are the common roots. We have considered here alpha is the common root. So what is the possibility for alpha? This is one possibility for alpha. And another possibility you will get if you consider the first two ratios. Okay. I am writing, noting down this part in my next page. After that I am discussing. Just wait. Okay. So how to find the common roots? After this part, process is same. Now, if we consider the first two ratios, then what? If we consider first and second ratios, first and second, then alpha square by BR minus CQ equals to alpha by PC minus AR. Implies that here we can cancel out one alpha. Why? Since there have not mentioned that alpha is 0. Okay, if and there is no chance also. If alpha is 0, then here C must be 0. That means here alpha is a common root. Suppose alpha equals to 0, then this 0 and this term 0, and it will be C equals to 0. That means for that type of quadratic equation, you will not get the constant term. That means suppose 2x square plus 5x. For this quadratic equation, one root must be 0. Okay, so if we consider that there is no chance such there is no such possibility, then we can cancel out alpha and alpha. Then here alpha by BR minus CQ equals to 1 by PC minus AR, implies that alpha equals to BR minus CQ by PC minus AR. So this is one possibility for alpha. And if you consider the second and third ratios, then what? Alpha by PC minus AR equals to 1 by AQ minus PB, implies that alpha equals to PC minus AR by AQ minus PB. So the possibilities for common roots, that means what are the possibility for common root? So common roots can be this or this. This is clear. So for every problem related to common root, you can solve by this method, this cross multiplication method. It is clear. I hope all of you understand this theory. Okay. Okay. Now I will solve a problem related to common root. See the question. For what values of m, the equation 3x square plus 4mx plus 2 equals to 0 and 2x square plus 3x minus 2 equals to 0 will have a common root. Okay. So to determine the value of m, actually this question will come in ISC, is of 5 marks. Okay. But when this question you will get in IIT exam or any other competitive exam, so how to solve? That time we will not follow the long method. Okay, we will follow the short method. Okay, short method means if you use the long method, then you have to consider that by the previous theory that alpha be the common root, after that alpha will satisfy both of the equation, after that by cross multiplication method alpha square by alpha by 1 by, and then you have to eliminate alpha. After that you will get the condition, and the condition will be the quadratic equation of m. After that you have to solve it. So now I will solve this problem by short method. Okay, so what was the short method? I told you that to determine the short method, I have to write the condition for common root. Condition for common root what was the condition? So we can write the condition. I told you that just write the coefficient. So here coefficient is 3. After that here coefficient is 4m, and here coefficient is 2 for the first quadratic equation. And for the second quadratic equation, it is 2. Here coefficient of x is 3, and this is minus 2. You have to consider the sign also. Don't forget it to consider the sign. Okay. So I told you first long diagonal you have to consider. So long diagonal means here 3 to the minus 6. Minus, according to the formula, minus. Next, this diagonal. This diagonal is 2 to the 4. So minus 6 minus 4. This whole square equals to, after that, this is 1 and second is this by this. So this is 3 to the 9 minus 4 to the 8m. Understood? Into, now for this, then minus 8m minus 6. So this is the condition. Now this is 6 plus 4, 10. 10 square means it will be 100, equals to, if you multiply 8, then 8 9 is 72m minus 6 9 is 54 plus 64m square plus 48m. Clear? Next, this is a quadratic equation of m. So if you arrange it, then it will be 64m square. It will be 12, I think. Okay, if you simplify these two, then it will be minus of, it is 14. Sorry, 4, 24m. Okay, 24m minus 154 equals to 0. This is the quadratic equation. Now you can divide it by 2, then it will be 32m square minus 12m minus 77. Okay, 77 equals to 0. So by middle term method we can do it. So if we since last sign is negative, so we have to match the term 12 by subtraction. So if we factorize 32, then we will get 2 to the power 5, and it is 7 into 11, 77 means. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 7 into 11. Okay, so 2 to the 4, okay, 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, okay, 56 and 44. If you subtract it, then you will get 12. So do it. So 56m plus 44m minus 77 equals to 0. Now take common, then here common will be 8, then 8m, then it is 4m minus 7. Here common will be 11. So it is 4m minus 7 equals to 0. So if we take common 4m minus 7, then 4m minus 7 into 8m plus 11 equals to 0. Therefore, either 4m minus 7 equals to 0 implies that m equals to 7 by 4, and or 8m plus 11 equals to 0 gives m equals to minus 11 by 8. So this is the value of m. Actually, this is a very long question. This question will not come in IIT, but just important is the condition, how to determine the condition without memorize. This was my main focus. Okay, actually this question will come basically in your ISC exam or WBHS. Clear? So okay students, I have solved here two important problems. In left hand side one problems and the solution is there, and in right hand side also another problem is there. Hope you will understand the solution, since आई हैव फॉलोड द सेम प्रोसेस व्हिच आई हैव यूज्ड टू डिराइव द कंडीशन फॉर कॉमन रूट. ओके, सो इट विल बी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड इट. सो यू कैन पॉज द वीडियो एंड नोट डाउन दिस बोथ सॉल्यूशंस. ओके, इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड एन एनी स्टेप देन यू कैन आस्क मी इन माई कॉमेंट. डेफिनेटली आई विल एक्सप्लेन अगेन.
Please subscribe my YouTube channel and press the bell icon so that you get the notification of all updates.